Today, I would like to talk to you about AI for computer science education. Now, that's a few words not everyone might be familiar with, so let's try to unpack it. So first of all, AI. Well, everyone is fed up with AI at this point, probably. I know I am. And it is artificial intelligence, right? Well, for me, I like to think of it as artificial intelligence. That's a word which is a bit scary, right? It's something that comes out of novels where robots take over the world, they kill every human, and it's not a nice thing. So a better way to think about it is augmented intelligence, where it actually helps us, AI helps us to become better people, to become smarter, to become faster, to become better problem solvers, etc. So when I think about AI, I think of it as a tool that augments our intelligence. Now, the other part of my title was computer science. And for that, I'd like to tell you a little story about a boy. Back in the middle of the 90s, this boy was sick one evening. His parents rushed him to the doctors, where he was playing around with stuff in the lobby, you know, crawling up to these little toys, fluffy toys and whatever. But there in the far corner, there was a little box which, you know, had some lights lit up. It made some funny noises. You know, this kid was really interested in what was happening. So he crawled up to it, and he saw a button, pretty much like the one on the right, that is a restart button. So he obviously went ahead and pushed it, waving goodbye to all the data that was on the computer the whole day, right? Because back in the 90s, data was a pretty different thing, and it wasn't stored as good as it is today. So every patient that day and every record that day was gone. So fast forward 30 years, a lot of funny family stories, and that guy, he actually became a PhD of computer science and is standing right here in front of you, giving you a TED talk about computer science. So why I wanted to tell you this story is because many, many things changed in the course of those 30 years. Major disruptions happened. Now, disruptions, as the Cambridge Dictionary puts it, are events that completely change the traditional way that an industry or a market is operating by using new methods or technology. And here, I wanted to list three of these major disruptions. The first one is the World Wide Web, right? The internet. So when the internet came about, that was an event that really fundamentally changed how we perceive things, how we consume knowledge, how we communicate with each other, how we educate, because books were not that required. They are not that required by today's standards. You can just go online, Google something, and then you will have a plethora of answers. The next thing, a more recent one, and most of us want to forget about it, is COVID, right? So COVID also was a major event. It caused some disruption because we all, as humanity, had to figure out that the way we are working, the way we are going to the office, is not necessarily a required way of doing things. We can do things remotely. We can even educate remotely because the university was closed down. Students weren't allowed in, professors weren't allowed in. So we had to adapt to this. And with using the communication technologies available for us, we could do that pretty well. Now, the third one, the most recent one, and I think one of the greatest ones here, is the emergence of augmented intelligence technology, or AI technology, right? Generative AI chatbots used for everything and anything. So they are changing the way that, once again, we are consuming knowledge. They are changing the way how we are creating and our computers, our phones, and everything around us. And this will also have a profound impact on how businesses are conducted, how people are working, how people are creating documents, how people are creating assignments, and how we are actually going through our everyday lives. So these systems, AI chatbots, also have a profound impact on our way of educating. Because we would like to educate the next generation of thinkers so that their skill set are matched up with the requirements of the industries, right? Of the employers, of their possible future employers. So this is something that students are feeling as well. And they are trying to use these technologies in their career or during their curriculum. So I stole this quote from Jeff Su, a YouTuber who said that in one of his videos, "Where was GPT when I was in college?" And that resonated with me very well, because this is a tool that would help a lot, that would have helped a lot, actually. And this day, I am using it every day. And I think many of you are using it every day as well. And I think that's the way, moving forward, things are going to be. And then, on the other side of the spectrum, there are university professors, like myself. Everyone said this at one point. Students are cheating. And they are cheating. But I wouldn't necessarily phrase it as cheating. I would say something like, this is the way, you know, that eases their burdens. They make it easier on themselves. And they are using smart ways to use new technological advancements in order to make their everyday lives easier. And I think it's smart. And it's a little bit of cheating as well. But mostly it's smart. So we realized this, that the requirements of the employers, of the businesses, is that students, and especially computer science students, need to have this skill set under their belts. They need to be able to use these technologies, these chatbots, if you will. And with our research group, we, with these amazing people in our research group, we are actually teaching a few subjects here at the university, computer vision courses for some people, for some computer science students. And we realized this, and we wanted to make it so that the technologies are embedded in the curriculum. So we introduced it in one of our practical courses, in the computer vision course, practical course. And actually, when we compare our practical courses this year, when we are using AI tools, against the practical courses of last year, when we weren't using these technologies, we see that there is a significant reduction of time spent with mundane, boring tasks, such as coding. We actually been able to reduce the amount of time taken for a practical course by more than 150% while conveying the same messages, the same amount of knowledge to our students. And there's an additional plus here, that we actually showed them, or we actually gave them the opportunity to experiment with AI tools, with generative AI chatbots. And as a result, well, we finished earlier, and when we asked our students about what they think about this kind of teaching that we just introduced, they overwhelmingly said that it was a good idea, a great experience, and that they want the other courses to introduce this technology. And I welcome this, and I urge everyone to do this, because when we think about AI as augmented intelligence and not as some scary stuff that will take our jobs in the future, we can actually create great opportunities. We can actually create the best future thinkers. So my message is this: let's use augmented intelligence and educate the future thinkers the right way. Thank you very much.